Tonight on Love Island.
I might have to put my fingers down my throat.
Kissing Sophie after she puked.
They're getting sick of Sophie.
Will you just go and f*** phone call?
Don't expect me to be happy.
I miss my mum so much.
And has Bianca blown it with Callum?
I think you're just playing with me.
My feelings are really hurt, actually. I don't want to quit.
Oh, f***.
So it is what it is. Don't even worry about it. Don't get me wrong.
Welcome to Love Island, where yesterday Sophie slipped Chris the tongue, Colleen slipped through Lee's fingers.
And despite using every trick in the book, Callum still not slipped into Bianca.
I know. Yes, as they returned from the Love Shack yesterday, Bianca had still not given in to the legendary charms of young Mr. Best.
Yet, Fern. Yet.
Come on then, baby. Listen, it's been fun. Give me a kiss. Been wicked.
And you, babe. Thank you.
After you.
Hello!
Hello, everybody.
Hello. Hey,
yeah, brother. Yeah.
Oh, honey.
Oh, baby.
Right.
Oh.
Oh.
Love Shack was an absolutely fantastic experience. I'm very glad that you put us in there. Had a fantastic time and enjoyed the experience. He's just an absolutely fantastic guy. He's really, really nice. And I couldn't ask for much more, really.
Dear celebrities, today's Daily Decider is called Suck or Chuck.
Oh, for
couples will be given 5 strips of pasta. Each celebrity will start at an end in their mouth. On my signal, you must start eating the pasta towards each other. When you reach your partner in the middle, you must kiss. Only then can you move on to the next plate of pasta. In dish one, we've got spaghetti in chili sauce.
Ooh. I thought you said this was easy.
In dish two, spaghetti in yeast extract.
Nice. Yeast.
And
extract.
It stinks.
I like a bit of Vegemite. Yeah, absolutely.
Dish three, spaghetti in strawberry sauce. Dish number four, spaghetti in mayonnaise.
Oh.
Dish number five.
Wait for it.
Spaghetti in treacle.
I'm going to go and throw it up after that. I'm allergic to, so I have to put my fingers down my throat. I'm allergic to pasta. I'm going to have bloody constipation for the next god knows how long.
Horrible. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Look at the length of that thing.
It's like pulling a tapeworm at your foot.
Oh, stop.
Oh, I thought that was like a little piece of spaghetti, too.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Yeah, I think you're just going to suck and then let the juice drip. Yeah, go on, Chris. Go on, Chris.
Go for the kiss, baby. Go for the kiss.
Oh my God. Good! Oh, he's like crying so hard. I'm coming.
Oh, I can't kill me.
Okay, excellent. Well done, guys. Colleen and Chris's time was 3 minutes, 25 seconds.
All right,
suck and swallow, baby. Oh, shit. It gets a bit messy in there.
I'm good at sucking and swallowing.
Great. There we go.
And go.
Ooh. He's after the kiss, look.
Yeah, she's doing a great time. Oh. Walking it down. Nice one. Excellent. Oh! Wow, their time was a staggering 1 minute, 41 seconds.
Yeah.
Ready, go.
Oh, oh, a little extra.
Well done. 2 minutes, 20 seconds.
Well done, well done.
So the time to beat is 1 minute, 41.
It wasn't that bad. I don't feel like that sick at all.
On your marks, get set, go.
Oh, cheating! Oh.
Double
cup.
Definitely cheating, Captain, that.
Mm-hmm.
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 Come on, babe.
What's wrong with me?
Come on, guys.
Hey, Marmite.
Woo! What was that time?
1:56.
Hell yes!
Actually, you know what? I might have to go put my fingers down my throat.
Really?
I can't eat pasta.
It's not nice.
Well, no.
Oh, it's that yeast. Ooh. Sorry, B, I've just got the burps. Thinking I might have to put my fingers in my throat.
Oh, don't tell me that. That's just disgusting.
I'm gonna have to try sticking it stuff in my throat.
When is it?
You want it?
So can she can just like stick her fingers down her throat and puke?
Oh, I think it's disgusting myself. Do you know what I mean? Like, how unattractive is that?
The noises, mate.
Keep it quiet.
It's disgusting.
What is
that?
Yeah, big turn on. Yeah. She's gonna be snuggling on her own. I think if you're gonna go do something like that, right? If you need to get your food up, just do it. You know, don't kind of like raise a flag and be like, guys, I'm gonna go stick my fingers down my throat and bring it all up. Because it's easy for me to do that. I was like, ooh,
Yeah, I've got mouthwash.
Okay.
No, seriously, brushed and washed.
It's something slightly acidic.
I brushed and washed my teeth.
Good. My favorite flavor was Colleen. The most disgusting taste was kissing Sophie after she puked.
Do we have to shoot that?
I think gag during that, very funny. So Chris's favourite flavour is Colleen, whatever that might be, but yeah. I'm guessing it's probably sweeter than Sophie.
Oh, dear God. And Sophie there throwing up before kissing Chris, as opposed to the rest of us who normally throw up after she kisses her. Well, how minging was that?
Right? Can anything... Mouthwash, yummy. Was it for me? But my lunch wasn't the only nasty thing to come out of Sophie's mouth.
Oh, no. There was plenty more bile where that came from.
Dear celebrities, today... one of you will have the opportunity to speak to a loved one.
Oh my God.
There is a phone call home available tonight. This is it now. Please decide amongst yourselves who gets the call.
Thank you.
I've already spoke to my mum.
Yeah, I'm okay. To my mum.
I think it's between...
I haven't even heard from my mum. I haven't even had a letter from her.
You both had letters.
Yeah.
I haven't had a letter from my mum.
You've had a letter.
You had a letter from
Arabella, but not from my mother.
Right. I don't think we have to decide now, so it's just up to.
I haven't even heard from my mum, and I don't even know whether my dad's okay or anything. So I
Have you heard from?
I've had a letter. Would you like a call? Of course you would.
You haven't even had a letter, have you?
I had one call to my mum.
Yeah, you guys.
We should. I think we should give it. Probably to be just because she's never been away from her family like this before. And
I agree, actually, yeah. But how's Sophie going to take
jungle.
That? I couldn't agree with you more.
It's down to you and
yeah,
B because you both.
She's had a letter from her mum. I haven't even heard from my parents.
Hey, sweetheart, you've also had a letter, okay? So I want you to get a grip on this. Come here, listen to me.
I'm fine, that's why I came in here on my own.
Yeah, well, I've come in here to talk to you as a friend. Would you listen to me?
I don't even talk about my parents and how much I miss them so just now. And I just...
Yeah, we're all feeling... I'm telling you, Sophie, we're all feeling the same, because I've had, in the last couple of days, I've been really homesick. But what we've got to understand is that, well, everyone else is bowed out of the phone call. Nobody else wants it, but there's between you and B.
Just
remember...
I'm happy to pass it to B.
OK, well, that's
she it. Needs it more than I do.
That's a good decision. That's what I'm trying to say to you. You know, you're a woman, right? And you're a worldly woman, hey?
Pass it to B. Just give it to her.
Because she needs it more than I do right now.
It's the right thing to do, but I know what you want to speak to your parents as well.
Fine, just give it to B. Leave it.
I'm not going to leave it because I want to talk to you as a friend.
Anymore. I've just said I want to hand it over to B.
Okay, then do that.
Fine, well, there you go.
No, I'm not going to say. You do it. You're the situation here.
Where is she?
Okay. Hey, listen.
It's
about being a you know.
Yeah, it's cool. It's cool. Just don't expect me to be happy.
I don't expect you to be happy, but we're all the same.
I want B to just get over all of this stuff. Where's Bianca? Bianca, you can have it. I don't want it.
No, you can have it.
No. B's having the phone call, not me. It's my decision.
Oh, well, no, sorry, you've come here, babe.
No, it's fine. I don't want to talk about it. I want you to have it, baby.
No, I need to go and talk to her.
No, I want you to speak to your mum, okay? I know how much it means to you.
And yeah, but it means a lot to you as well, babe.
I'm 29, I'm older and uglier than you, I can handle it.
But you want to speak to your mum.
Yeah, but you need to. You want to know what is going on back at home more than I do.
No, I can't take it.
Yes, well, you're going to have to. You're going to have to, because I refuse to take it. I've made the decision.
Sophie's deciding.
Yeah, but then.
Please, just go and take it, Bianca.
Yeah, just take it, sweetheart. Go for it.
Will you just go and it, phone call? Oh, just think.
Probably the most selfless thing I've done in this entire show, and it hurts. I'm glad that she's going to have a chance to speak to her mum, because what hurts more is I'm watching her drinking herself into a mess every night and eating, like, bucket loads of food. I miss my mum so much.
Try not to.
No, I just feel bad, do you know what I mean? You know me, Lee.
You're right.
Mm. And you?
I just feel bad, do you know what I mean?
Don't.
Do.
Well, don't.
If you know me any better than that, I do just feel like bad about everything like that. But I'll tell you what, I'm ecstatic.
Good, that's better.
Oh.
That's more like it.
No. It wouldn't sit right with me taking phone calls from my mum. My mum would agree with me and she'd do the same, baby. My mum would totally understand. My mum's cool, she understands my reasonings.
Yeah.
Okay?
But I'm trying to think what I can do for you, but I just can't think of
anything. Baby, just be you. And if we both survive this eviction, then it gets you through the next week.
Yeah, no, don't
on an even keel, because you haven't been yourself.
Yeah.
You've been drinking more than you normally do. And I'm being honest.
Yeah.
And you've been eating more than you normally do. And I think speaking to your mum will get you back on track in your own head.
Yeah, totally.
Is that cool?
Very cool.
Do you think I'm wrong?
No, I don't think you're wrong. But well, I'm still...
So that's my reasoning. Okay.
Welcome back to Love Island, where before the break, Sophie selflessly turned down the chance to phone home so Bianca could make the call she so desperately wanted.
Sadly, though, the pizza shop was shut, and so she called home instead.
Paddy!
No, Fern, according to Sophie, Bianca's turned into a fat alco. So after winning, not my words, so after winning the Daily Decider, what better treat than to put in her belly a big three-course lunch washed down with a glug-glug nice bottle of champagne.
Oops.
Yum-yum.
I got that for you, though.
Oh, thank you, darling.
You're welcome. Suits your top, though. Yeah. When I picked it, that's what I was thinking.
Oh, really?
Looks pretty.
Thank you.
Excuse me, baby.
Appetite.
Yeah. I'm glad we got to have another lunch, just you and me.
Oh, definitely.
It's quite nice.
Well, that was definitely well worth it.
You were well worth it.
Cheese.
No respect.
I've got lots of respect.
None whatsoever.
I do.
Want just orange? No, didn't think you would.
Fuck.
Shit.
Says you're nasty.
No, I'm not. I'm a very kind, nice person.
When you want to be.
I thought you wanted to be here.
I do. Let there be you. Oh, that was nice.
Wasn't it, babe?
I think you're just playing with me.
I wouldn't do that. I'd like to. To be honest.
Do you know what? I didn't even see that one coming, which I usually would. Sparkling champagne. You're just trying to get me drunk.
You like puppy dog eyes, you know that?
I express myself through my eyes.
Yeah. It's a good look.
Not bad.
I like it.
Thanks.
I'll give you a hug if you need one.
Thank you.
Well, I'm more than happy.
You are trying to get me drunk.
Don't need to.
You do.
Not so much. There.
Mm-hmm.
How's the cake?
It's sexual.
Is that right? Voila.
Oh, thank you.
Happy with that?
Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove, but first of all, please let there be love.
Happen, Paddy. Read the signs. You're only having a cigarette after sex. It's not happening.
Oh, no, no. It's Callum Best. He knows what he's doing. Give it a day or two, and she will be.
Well, you sound very confident.
I do.
You're confident.
I am.
Unlike Paul Bianca.
Anything really happens with Callum, that's it. Yeah. With the Leo situation.
Yeah, well, of course. Yeah.
I love this girl. Come here. Cool. There you go. Was it like?
No. Oh, yeah.
Oh. God.
Alrighty. Welcome.
Thank you.
You've been with Chris, Leo,
and Paul.
And Callum.
Oh, well, we'll get on with it.
Am I with a couple?
Yeah, you're a couple now.
Joy.
Okay. So, which one is the most honest?
To me, in like just in general, even though Leo was very honest to me, wasn't very honest in some cases, it would have to be Chris, because everything that I ask him, he will give me an honest answer back.
Which one is the most humorous?
I'd have to say all three, because all for different reasons. Obviously, Paul was just hilarious in every kind of way. Chris is just generally funny, and so was Leo as an entertainer. And Callum as well.
No, okay. Cool. It's all good.
Okay. Oh, I'm not thinking that I'm in a couple.
You
that's
are.
Why. Oh, okay.
Yeah. Which one has the greatest intelligence?
Probably Leo, purely because he's very intelligent in like the mind, and he knew how like my mind worked and my insecurities and things, and like helped me through that.
Yeah, there you go. Good. Sympathetic?
It would have to be Leo again, purely because he kind of really supported me when I was feeling down.
Mm. Which one are you most compatible to?
It would have to be Callum.
Okay.
That was so hard. And sorry, Callum, I forgot about you at the beginning, babe. Sorry.
That was some deep and meaningful shit there.
I would have liked to. Oh, I just hated it. It was horrible. Oh, I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings. And I didn't like comparing people to each other. Brendan, it was the worst thing ever.
You know, you can't compare two people. This is my ultimate thing in life. You cannot compare you and me as to who's best at whatever, because we've both got our own qualities, we're completely different people.
I was in such a good mood and now I'm like... Come on, I need some of your f***ing issues.
How's everything?
I think that game just totally blew it.
I suppose you didn't say Callum for any of us.
You did.
Oh, you did? Which one?
Most compatible for.
You guys get along really well.
I just think that whole f***ing game is kind of like blew it, basically.
Yeah.
Which kind of sucks.
My feelings are really hurt, actually, because B didn't pick me for any of them. I think I want to quit. Right.
Basically, when I was explaining it, not being funny, I did forget that I was in a couple of you purely because of all the month and a week that I've had here.
It makes sense. It doesn't somewhat, doesn't it?
No, no, but at the same time, it was just like, oh,
so it is what it is. Don't even worry about it.
Why are you annoyed then?
I'm not annoyed at all. I'm just here to have a laugh. It's all good.
Yeah, I know you are.
Cool, no worries.
But there's something different.
No, not at all. It's just one of them things, you know, it's like, maybe we're here hanging out, but if you got some things you're dealing with there and some things there, it's just like, I just can't be bothered.
Even what I said, I just don't want to mean it, but I just don't want to hurt people. And do you know what I mean? It's just, it's stupid. It really is. But then at the same time, I was really pissed off afterwards, purely because, like...
You were so kind.
Shut up. I just wanted to explain myself, so then I felt better.
Okay. Whatever makes you feel better, baby. The reality is we've only known each other a couple of days, so it's just take it how it comes, and you're cool and I enjoy your company.
Totally.
Think you're gorgeous, but...
But I would really love to know what the butt was in that.
It's just, I don't even really know how to put it, but it's like coming on here after you've been through an experience you've been through. It's like I'm thinking, yeah, you're cool and I like you and you're gorgeous, but sometimes I'm like, do I even want to really... get into something where there's like, you know, the fact you've been on this show and you've had like a, you know, it's just kind of some of, yeah.
Yeah, no, I do understand what you're saying.
Yeah, cool.
Totally.
That was painfully icky, wasn't it? And even Bianca thinks she's blown it.
Look, trust me, Fern, if she'd blown it, he'd have already moved on to the next woman.
Yeah, very true, Paddy. But as Callum plays it cool with Bianca, for the rest of the celebs, things are hotting up. Coming up on Love Island...
The sexual frustration there is ridiculous.
Temperatures are rising.
Colleen's shorts.
Look at that!
Sophie, like, I'm wearing shorts too. Not like Colleen, you know.
Love spending time with Chris.
There's a lot of erections going around.
Nice.
Fun and games. And honestly, I have to say, right, any guys there, set the video because Colleen's hot pants are very, very, very special. Turn over now to ITV2. I just had to say
that's
that.
That's a trait.
To Matt and Jane, we're ready with somewhere after sun, including a live chat with Bianca.
We'll see you after the news. Goodbye.
Remember the hot pants.